Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Tomasz Bigaj. I'm a current visiting fellow at the center here. My permanent affiliation is with the University of Warsaw, Poland. I'm holding a position of professor of philosophy at the Institute of Philosophy there. And this is not my first visit in Pittsburgh. I've been here on different occasions, mostly conferences and talks, but of course I'm for the first time here as a fellow, and I'm thoroughly enjoying this experience. This is a wonderful place to be, excellent environment, nice atmosphere, beautiful office with a stunning view of the city, so I'm really trying to get the best of this time that I have here. So let me tell you a little bit about my current research and my scientific interests. My general area of interest is philosophy of physics, with particular emphasis on the ontological and metaphysical issues that arise in the context of physics. Now, ontology and metaphysics deals with fundamental questions regarding the nature of reality, such as the issue of causation, spatiotemporality, ontological categories of objects, and so on and so forth. And as it turns out, physics has a lot to say about these issues, and what it says very often contradicts our common sense and our intuition. So I think as philosophers we should be very sensitive to the message that we get from physics as science. And in particular, one particular problem that I've been working on recently is the issue surrounding the notion of individuality, identity, and discernibility. Let me give you a particular example. Let's look at these two objects here, these two coffee mugs. What makes them individual, separate entities that I can somehow pick out, that I can separate, individuate, refer to individually? A simple answer to that question would be that they differ with respect to some properties. For instance, they differ with respect to their colors. One is light green, the other one is dark navy blue. They may differ with respect to the shapes and so on and so forth. So generally speaking, they differ with respect to their properties. But now we can ask this general question, is it always true, is it always warranted that if we take any two or any number of objects, there will always be some qualitative difference between these two objects? And there is one possible answer to this question. It comes in the form of the venerated principle, the principle of the identity of indiscernibles, formulated by the German philosopher Leibniz, which says basically that for any two numerically distinct objects, there will always be some qualitative difference. Unfortunately, physics in general and quantum mechanics in particular, as one of the most important theories in physics, actually cast some doubts on the validity of this principle, because as it turns out, the way quantum mechanics describes the groups of individual objects, such as elementary particles, protons, electrons, neutrons, neutrinos, that sort of thing, it turns out that the mathematical way in which quantum mechanics describes these states requires certain mathematical properties of symmetry with respect to so-called permutations. So if we permute, shuffle objects within a particular state, the resulting state should be either identical with the original one, or at least it should at most differ with respect to the sign. And one important consequence of this symmetrization, as we call it in physics, is that individual states of separate objects do not differ from one another. So individual electrons are like in the same state no matter what. They have the same properties. They cannot be distinguished from one another. So this, of course, raises the issues of are individual electrons or protons really individuals, or maybe they just create something like electron-like stuff that cannot be separated into smaller components in a metaphysical sense. And some people are happy with this solution, but some other people try to find some alternative approaches. Another alternative approach that I would like to mention here is the approach based on the notion of weak discernibility. Weak discernibility is something, going back to these mugs, is something that takes into account some relation, like for instance the relation of being separated by some distance, non-zero distance. These two cups are separated by non-zero distance, but no cup is separated from this distance from itself, so this creates some sort of difference in this. And it turns out that in quantum physics, quantum particles can be separated, can be somehow connected by these weakly discerning relations. Unfortunately, there's some conceptual and technical problems related to that, and some people object to this entire project of weak discernibility. In my current research, actually, I'm focusing on yet another possible approach, which tries to rehabilitate the notion of the old ordinary notion of discernibility, at least in some cases. And basically, I am focusing on the possibility of finding, of discerning quantum particles in a totally symmetric way. And just a simple example, if I want to discern two particles, let's say particle one and particle two, normally I would say like particle one possesses one property, let's say it's red. Just an artificial example. Particle 1 is red, particle 2 is green. So this is like an asymmetric way of discerning them. But we can say it symmetrically by saying, we can do it symmetrically by saying that particle 1 is red, either particle 1 is green and particle 2 is red, or particle 1 is red and particle 2 is green. And this is kind of like symmetric. And it turns out that in the quantum mechanical formalism, there's a way to express this, which can partially rehabilitate the notion of so-called absolute discernibility by properties. I'm currently involved in some technical issues surrounding this particular approach, trying to deal with some objections to this new approach. And all in all, the upshot of this whole project will be that in many situations, quantum particles act as if they were individuals, and this somehow can show that maybe our worries regarding their status as individuals was kind of premature. But I think at this point I should probably stop.